All right, so to kick things off, we're gonna first talk about the two workflows that the Synchronization API provides. The first is the storage workflow, and the second is the manifest workflow. And the difference between these two workflows is where exactly the source design files are stored. Now, they do have to be stored in the cloud for the Synchronization API to work on them. It's a completely web-based API. But in the case of the storage approach, the files are stored within the iTwin itself in a service called the iTwin Storage. Whereas in the manifest approach, the files are stored in an external DMS, such as Azure Blob Storage or Microsoft SharePoint. And these files are directly pulled into the Synchronization API. Now, which approach would you go with? That really depends on if you already have a place in the cloud where you're storing your files. If you don't already have a place, then the storage workflow might be for you. Every time you create a new iTwin, not only do you get access to the iTwin, but a host of other services that accompany the iTwin. The iModel is one of them, and so is iTwin Storage. The iTwin Storage is a cloud storage that comes with the iTwin. It can be used to store any files associated with your project. You can also use it to upload your design files, so the Synchronization API can pull them in and synchronize them into the iModel. Now, you may already have a place in the cloud where you store your design files, some external DMS. We support quite a few. We support Azure Blob Storage, SharePoint, AWS, and many more. As long as the DMS you're using can generate pre-authenticated URLs to access the files, they can be directly pulled into the Synchronization API and synchronized into the iModel. So we have sample applications that demonstrate both these workflows. And what we're going to do now is go through a quick demo of both these samples so we can understand these workflows better. We'll start out with the storage sample. So here's what the app looks like. It comes with this nice drag and drop area. We can literally drag our design files. So I have a couple of design files here, a MicroStation building and a Revit building, and I can select them and drag and drop. So I do have this application configured with an iTwin and an MTI model, and we start uploading the files into the iTwin storage for this particular iTwin. And you can see that the files were successfully uploaded and we have kicked off a synchronization job. While we wait on the synchronization job to run, you will see that the files were successfully uploaded in the iTwin storage for this particular iTwin. Now going back, we're gonna give this process a couple of minutes. While we wait though, I do wanna mention that this approach is very straightforward. You don't have to invest in any extra external resources to manage your design files. You can simply drag and drop your files onto a page like this and get started with your iTwin. So that's the big benefit of using the storage workflow. And you can see that both of the files were successfully synchronized. Next, let's take a look at the manifest sample app. Now, in this case, we're going to store our files in Azure Blob Storage. We'll use that as an example. I have the same two files, the MicroStation and Revit building, this time in an Azure Blob Storage, and we're going to use the Manifest Sample app to pull them in and synchronize from there. So here's what the Manifest Sample looks like. Here's a table of files from external storage. So this application is already configured with that same Azure Blob Storage, and that's how it's pulling these files, the two files within this interface. It's also configured with an MTI model, just like the storage app that we saw. And all we have to do now is hit synchronize, and it will kick off a synchronization process and start writing the design data from these files into the iModel. So you can see that the synchronization process is now running on both files. Once again, we're gonna give this process a couple of minutes to finish up. And you can see the files were successfully synchronized. Now, the big benefit of this approach is that anytime there are changes made to these design files where they're being managed, no extra effort needs to be done to transfer those changes to the iTwin platform. The DMS is already connected to this application, and all it's going to take to get our latest design changes into the iModel is a simple click of the button. All right, awesome. So now you know the two workflows that the Synchronization API comes with. At this point, let's take a step back and actually understand what goes on behind the scenes in the synchronization process. So in the next video, let's understand some key synchronization concepts.